YouTube fam, it's your girl Leah back again with another video. In today's video, as you can see from the title, it is a part two to my LumaFusion tutorial on how I edit all my YouTube videos. Now, I, like I mentioned in part one of this video, have edited every single video that you've seen on this platform on my iPad. That is right. I've never edited a video on a computer. I've never edited a video on a phone, on another device. It has always been my handy dandy iPad, and I've gotten over 100,000 subscribers from it. People think, you know, I have to have all this fancy tech. I have to have Final Cut Pro, Adobe Premiere, iMovie, you know, I have to have some lavish software to be able to get to 100,000 subscribers. But I got a plaque. I got a plaque, and I've never edited a single video on a single computer system. It's possible. It's totally possible to grow and be successful on this platform and not have to spend thousands and thousands of dollars on fancy editing software, because people like to be visually pleased with the content that they watch. Of course, you don't want to make subpar content, but if the content and the quality of what you're saying is good, then the editing doesn't have to be, again, motion picture level quality. And that's what we're going to get into today. We're going to get into today how I edit on my iPad, a little bit of a beefed up version. Now, my part one, it told you everything. How I get my videos from the camera, because I'm recording my video on a camera. I'm not recording it on the iPad itself. I'm recording on a Canon G7X Mark II. I show you just basic functionalities of LumaFusion. I talk about the price. At the time I purchased it, it was $19.99. I have been told recently that it is $29.99 on the App Store. It is a one-time purchase fee. Again, as somebody who has over 100,000 subscribers, paying that price 4 years ago, $19.99, it only cost me $20 back then, and it has lasted me months and months and months and months since. I'd say it was a $20 purchase worth having, especially for me having already had an iPad at that point. Now, over the years, I have, of course, upgraded an iPad since then, but I get into price. I get into just the basic specs of LumaFusion. So if you have any questions about that, check out that first video. I probably answered it, so I don't want to belabor that point. I just want to switch over and switch gears, and you guys see me as I edit. So again, part one, I go over downloading LumaFusion. So this is what it looks like on the iPad. And then this is a project that I was working on. I color coordinate, which I talk about in my first video. I color coordinate projects I'm currently working on. So I'm currently working on 4 active projects right now, just because right now as I'm filming this, I'm in a downtime where we're between holidays, and I have a little bit of time and a lot more capacity. So I'm editing 4 videos at a time. I typically wouldn't do this. In the last video, I talked about just the basics. So this is a video, a project that is fully fleshed out. I've edited it and everything, but I record, I'd say, 2 types of videos on this channel. Today's video is a little bit different. I think it fits more in the sit down chit chat realm of things, but I do sit down videos like this, which is was an install video. I was installing a hair in my head, so I do a lot of sit down videos. And the second type of video I film is like a vlog video. So this is my Cabo vlog that you might have seen if you watch my channel. So I vlog style. Vlog style is a lot different, I'd say, in terms of editing than my sit down videos, because I'm taking you through a lot more different scenes. It's not me sitting in my house, it is me everywhere. And so the editing on this is a lot more cuts, it's a lot more labor intensive. But something that I talked about in my last video, something that has helped me, is some things that you guys see pop up in my video. So if you see in this video right now, a subscribe button, a like button pop up, even my handle kind of comes up at a certain point. I can make it come up on screen right now as I'm recording. Even this voiceover, my handle can come up. And how did I do that, you may ask? That's a little bit more. That takes a little bit more effort. Now, 2 things. You can make things like this. Like, you can make certain things like this. It takes a lot of keyframing. What I mean when I say keyframing is, if I go back to this video, keyframing this video, I had a lot of clips being added in, which is, if you see that first bar, it's different than a lot of my videos. I don't typically have a lot of clips, but this video was well researched and I needed a lot of clips. But if I wanted to keyframe something, and that means that I go in and I create an overlay title, click on that overlay title to be able to edit this. And again, I talk about this in my first video, but say I want, this is not a, I don't want this to be a text box. I want a real box, like a box to come in and shoot in on the side. I want this box to kind of shoot in from the side. How would I make that box shoot in from the side? I would keyframe it. And what that means is I would go to this. Right now, the box is going to stay in throughout the whole clip at the same point. So you see how it's staying at the same left. But say I want it to kind of zoom in, like I want it to come on over. What I would do is right now at position one, right now at this particular moment, I want this box to be not on the screen. How would I move it off the screen? Well, I would change the position. I want it off the screen. That's where I want it to start. That's where I want it to be as I'm starting this video. So I put a keyframe. So I tap this button. That's where I want it to be at 23 minutes. At 23 minutes and 39 seconds, this is where that box should be. Where do I want it to be, though, 5 seconds in? Well, now I kind of want it to be a little bit in. I want it to be a little bit in. So then I create a new box. You see that little dot that appeared right there? Now at that mark, that's where that box is gonna be. It'll have moved in a little bit to that specific place. But then say, where do I want it to be right here? Like at that point. Well, I want it to be a little bit more. So I go to the radius or the X position, and that's where I want it to be at that point. So when I watch the video back now, the box at that point,
I still felt comfortable in my app space, but
So you saw how that box came in. I made that box come in, and now if I want text on top of that, if I want to put Lea LaVon now, or if I want to put like a certain thing, so let's go into it. Say I want my name or something, so create a new thing, put text in there, make it yellow text, and say Lea LaVon. Let's let it just say Lea LaVon. Let's not put it in any fancy titles. Let's put that there. Lea LaVon. So now it's a frame box, a frame shape, and the words Lea LaVon. So now when I play it,
still felt comfortable in my app space.
So now it says Lea LaVon, and I could add Instagram to it. I could do all of this to it, and I could actually make that like its own little preset so that every single video that Lea LaVon would pop up when I needed it to. I could make it its own thing. However, I'm lazy and I don't want to do all this. So I purchased this past year. So within the last 6 months, I said, hey, it's time to invest in my channel. I want good things for my channel. So I went to this YouTuber that I love, and I follow his channel. I'll link his channel up above right now and down below, but his channel is YouTube. It's called Rob HK. He is a tutorial guru. So if you are watching LumaFusion tutorials, you need to make sure you're watching his tutorials, because he's a masterpiece at this. He is a phenom at this. He's amazing at LumaFusion. He knows it in ways that I don't even know it. He has his own website. This isn't sponsored by him. This was my own decision buying this with my own coin. He has certain packages and creator bundles for like LumaFusion, Final Cut Pro, Lightroom. I use LumaFusion, so I go to his LumaFusion tab, and he has so many different things that you can buy from him. LUTs, which I'll talk about in a minute, floaty pop-ups, paper transitions, lower thirds, transition bundles, spin transitions. He has so many things that, yes, you could create on your own. It would take nothing to create anything that's on his page, from page two and all of that. And you wouldn't have to spend $5 here, $19 here. You wouldn't have to spend any of this. But he does have this, and it's for people like me who don't want to spend the time to keyframe every single thing out there. You can buy like a lot, a multiple pack bundle, which is like $19. You can do all of that. That is my secret to success when it comes to lower thirds and all of that. So again, I can make it like I did this one. I made this one. It's pretty much nothing. You can have anything. You can, you know, make this a different color. You can make it a different font. You can do whatever you want to do. You can add images in there. So you want a snowflake to come in too. You want a little thing. You can actually add in so much and it can change so much. But say, again, you don't want to do that. So I've purchased a few of Rob's packages. And what I mean is some of these packages are like his lower thirds package. So when my Lila Lavon comes in, it's because I purchased this package from him that just you create. When you buy it, it doesn't say Lila Lavon, it says his thing. Say I want it to pop in, and again, I could 100% probably make this. I could 100% make this. It would take me some time, but I truly could make this, and so can you, just with keyframing. And if I want to put it somewhere, I just go to the project where I want to put it, and then this is where I want it. I want Lila Lavon to pop up on the screen right here. So what's gonna happen is I'll click the player. So Lila Lavon comes up on the screen, and that's what I would do. And his lower thirds has so many different, doesn't have to be that, it can be, he has boxes that pop up, he has subscribe buttons, he has this, he has that, he has that, he has YouTube, and it all is his handle when you first go in. But you of course can go in, you click on it, and you change it to your handle. So you just go in and I say I want my WhatsApp to be at, I'm not familiar with WhatsApp. I probably chose the wrong one, but maybe it would be like your name on WhatsApp. So Lila Lavon, and then it's my handle now. And then I would just, again, copy this and put this in my project. I've used Aaliyah's face in a video before, so I had hers in there, Facebook, Twitter, YouTube, if you wanted to pop up right there. Same thing goes for, I bought his floaty pop-up. So if you ever see a like button pop up in my video, which you'll probably see at the end of this, that is this. I just copied this. Again, go to the bottom, copy it, pasted it into my video. So I hold these projects in, and anytime I need like a subscribe button, I need any of these things, I just go through that. I've bought so many of his different transitions and so many of his different essential packs. So this was like a, if I want the YouTube to come over to the side, and I want these and I want that, as well as I've purchased some of his wording packs. So again, all you have to do to create these is just simple keyframing. Keyframing, again, if I go into his project, all I have to do is go and see what he did. He keyframed a lot. You see, he has a lot of keyframes to make this do what it does. It's easy to, I would say, not easy, but it's, you probably look and say, oh, that's so simple. You can make words do that. Yeah, you can, but you'd have to keyframe a lot to get this feature as opposed to paying for it. So keyframing is a essential part of, if you want text to fly in, if you want words to fly in, if you want things to fly in. These aren't separate ones. These are, I bought one package and it came with 30 different things. He also has transition. So if you want to have transitions in your videos that are outside of the normal transitions that LumaFusion provides, he has like customized, like, hey, he has tutorials on his channel on how to actually use these. But that is my secret. I'm letting you in on my secret of how I have created so much. Even when it comes to some of my intros and some of my vlog videos, you might notice that if you've noticed on my Cabo vlog, I'll insert my Cabo one right now. That intro, I've used his LumaFusion pack. He has a pack to create intros like that. They can be longer, they can be shorter, they can be customized. Again, all you have to do is go to the specific projects. So again, this is that project. You just have to go in and put your pictures where you want them. So this is his like, just, you know, standard pictures. These are pictures that he has in there, but I want to use my pictures. So I'm going to go in and just grab, say I want this picture to be part of it. All I do is I drop it in here, keep that, and then my photos can replace that photo. And then I have an intro that I can use in my video. What I found is that with my vlogs, a lot of the times they do really well if I start the video off with, you know, some kind of thing that shows you overall what's coming in the video. You're seeing moments that are taken from the vlog itself, so the food I ate, and just some pictures of us at the dolphin show. Like, you can go and utilize that, and then that creates the intro to my video that starts here with text that swooped in that was, again, keyframe. You can make this. I could make Saturday come in. It's just going to take a lot of work that I didn't want to do, so that's why I bought the packages. Editing is not a hard task, and that's coming from somebody who I know I've been doing this for years, but it can be made so much easier if you want to invest in things like that. He has many LUTs too. I believe I purchased some of his LUTs. LUTs change the view of it, or change the color. I find that his coloring can be a little bit dramatic for a sit down video. So if I go to user LUTs, some of his LUTs, again, this is a darker color, it's a different color. This color, that's not too bad. I like that LUTs. That LUTs is a cute LUTs. It's not changing too much, and that's what it looks like without it. If you click on the eye, it gives you a view of what it looks like with it, what it looks like without it. So that's what that eye means. But he has LUT packages. Most of the time I find myself just using the natural color of the video itself, because I do try to film in open lighting, but sometimes you're in a darker space and you need to upgrade that lighting. You can do so many things. If I need this to be blurry, I've blurred out things. If I want it to be crystal, I never use this, but say I need it to be crystals or glass distortion, you can do that as well. So that's my secret. I got some questions in my last video. What's your secret to doing all this and keyframing and getting things to fly in and do all that? How did you get this? How did you get that? How did you get... Well, my secret again is that I use help. I use help. Rob HK, again, he has a site, he has a channel. He has a channel where he teaches you keyframing in there. So if you want to actually learn, he doesn't make you just buy his packages. He actually tries to teach you. I've actually watched some of his tutorials before, and then I realized I'm gonna just buy it. Yeah, it's simple enough. Again, a simple keyframe, a simple, like, I'll make one right now that'll come in. I didn't buy this one. I'll make one. But I'm sure future me is hating me for making this, because it takes quite some time to make this pop in with keyframing. Keyframing, you can get things flown in, you can get things timed in, you can raise up cinematic bars. If I want cinematic bars on me right now, like I'm talking in a movie theater, I can do that by simple keyframing. That's simple enough. If I want the bars to go down as I'm talking, those types of things, it's a simple keying shapes and keying things in. But overall, that's what I have. If you have any questions, leave them down below. I'm happy to make a third video. I don't know what much more I can teach you that is not already on this internet, but I am happy to help. Make sure you give this video a big thumbs up now that you figured out how I secretly put this thumbs up in here. And then make sure also that you're subscribed to me. I make this happen. I make the transition between the cursor hitting here to here. I keyframe that in every single time. Since I don't know how far off from the left or the right of the screen that I'm going to be, I make those keyframes. So I hope that was helpful for you to learn today, and make sure that you're following me on Instagram at LeahLavon89 so you can keep up with my shenanigans in real time, and I'll catch you in my next video. Thank you so much for watching. Bye.